Hey everybody, what's up? I'm the Madman, welcome back to another Wednesday night live stream session of Outlast. What have I got myself into? So how's everybody doing today? Good? Well, my day's about to go south and pretty fucking fast. Cause why? Cause I know what's coming up. You thought just exploring the lobby of this mental asylum was bad. Guess what? We're now in the freaking hellhole of it. Let's continue. Let's continue with the game. And no, again, that is not buffering from Twitch. That's the buffering of the game. And Grooming Space 2 just commented on my activity on Xbox. Cool. Oh, thank God I woke up. For a second there, I thought I wasn't... I'm still here. Hey, he also left me my video camera. Thank God, otherwise there would be no purpose for playing this game anymore. Rest in peace. Lovely. Yeah. Rest in peace. Remember the notes added to your notebook when camcorder is raised to record events. Oh, jeez! Father Martin's cell. The priest, Father Martin, brought me here trying to show me something. Thinks I'm going to be his witness for whatever batshit crazy he's trying to sell me. This Dr. Wanker? Winnicky? I don't know. Is at the center of whatever went wrong here. But he died more than 10 years ago. Rest in peace, says the blood on the wall. And the writing's on the wall. Literally! Hey, Anthony's here and Anna's here. Welcome to my nightmare. This place looks like it's up on the level. Jesus! Oh, fuck. Why don't you just stay in there for a while?
Who's this?
Maybe Father Martin's man.
Maybe.
He looks nervous.
I would like to kill him.
As would I.
The preacher asked us not to.
It won't be
you. Look like I've seen a god here. There's an idea.
Jeez. Well, technically, that guy's just like me after a long day at work.
They're in my blood and they want to get out.
And he's just gonna bang himself. Talk about a headbanger. Ow. Oh, God, even hearing it still. Whoa, shit.
Sleep no more.
And I've honestly completely forgotten how the fuck I'm supposed to get out of here. And unfortunately, guys, in this game, some of these inmates don't wear pants. Yeah, so let's try and avoid that. And let's also try and avoid getting hit with any, you know, copyright strike or flags or any of that shit. Because, you know, I like to keep my job. Yeah, those guys don't wear pants. Let's just say, previous experience. Haven't gotten in trouble for it, but, seriously, where the fuck am I supposed to go? Oh, I see what I'm supposed to do. I'm supposed to shimmy across. Wait, how the fuck am I supposed to shimmy across?
They're in my blood if they want to get out. Heal.
Fuck. Jesus, man. God. Whoa. Jeez, dude. I don't think I'm supposed to open this door. No, thank God. Am I supposed to escape using an air vent or something? I'm honestly quite lost right now, guys. Well, I just chose the door at random, hoping to... Fuck this place. Seriously, just fuck this place. Dying keeps moving lower on the list of the worst things that could happen to me here. Well, we also have Cult Chaz here. Welcome to the show, man. I'm just gonna crack open my beer right now just because. Because why not? Hey! That guy was actually normal. Then again, what constitutes as normal in this place? Oh my god, they took all my fucking batteries too. Shit, I only got two. Oh, fuck. Poor bastard. Okay, I've never worked in a mental institution before, but aren't you allowed to have a firearm or something? I mean, in Arkham Asylum, you're allowed a firearm. And we also have a person named Juicy Juice. You know, I'm sorry. With all due respect, I ain't reading the rest of that gamer tag. Whoa, 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 whoa!
I didn't wait until I finished, but I saved some for you.
Okay, that guy is gonna try and kill me. God always provides way, follow the blood. Great. Oh yeah, decontamination room. It's not exactly shocking when you know what it is. Is there a battery or something around here? Yep, I had a feeling. I'll just take this, thank you. They said follow the blood. Wow, I thought I've seen malnourishment. Excuse me, sir. Excuse me, sir. How do you feel about this year's election? Down the drain? I agree with you on this. This election is going down the drain. Alright. Helen, dear Zenentry, gave me your info to contact regarding the cancellation of the arts program. My patient, Archimede. Seriously, what is with half these names? And oh yeah, Juicy is... I can't believe I'm saying that aloud. Juicy is correct. There are literally two naked men walking around in this asylum. Those were the guys who were talking, they're like, I would wish to kill him. Yes, so would I. So yeah, that's the part that I'm trying to, you know, avoid showing with the video camera because, well, let's face it. I do have these live streams set to, like, mature audiences, but I still don't want to get in trouble for it. Alright, his therapy account has made enormous strides in his therapy on account of his finger painting. Then again, finger painting has always just been fun. Just in the weeks since cancellation of the arts program, his schizophrenic assertions of some higher calling have accelerated enormously. Ah, shit. Please, just let the man have finger paint. The few dollars you're saving on tempered paint is more than swallowed by the cost of clozapine. Probably a drug or something. I can't imagine the logic at play here, unless Markov wants our patients to become more disengaged from reality. I get it. Oh, shit. Close the door. It will slow your pursuers. Oh. Ah, shit. Hello? Anybody here? Heh. Coffee! $5 says Red Barrel. Conjuring? Never seen it. Okay, I guess, is there anything else in here? Just places I can hide and shit. Alright. Fuck. Ah, damn. Oh yeah, I can't open that door. Alright, let's have some fun.
Just shut up! Let me think for a minute! Quiet! Quiet!
I'm just gonna be quiet and give that man some time to think. Oh yeah. Wow. Can you say total setup? Hey, holy crap, it's that guy at the end of the episode me and Anna watched on American Horror Story Asylum. What the hell is he holding? Oh yeah, that's a nightstick. Alright. 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 1, 2. Okay, that was anticlimactic. What the hell is that? Oh, it's a lamp. Oh shit. Left bumper, run, please. Very fast. Thank you. Woo! Oh, that took him a good time. Please don't guess right. Please don't guess right. Go talk to a religious nut job over there. Strong motherfucker. Hey, and Matt Beard is here. Matt Beard, welcome to the show. Okay, is that guy still in there? I'm afraid to look up. Hi. Yeah, he's still in here.
I
so as long as I stay quiet, it seems to keep him calm. That's pretty cool. Yep. They definitely made it for like every psychopath that has like a new trigger mechanism. Most of the time it's sound or something. I'll just shut this. Alright, let's take a look. Anything else in here I can use? Nope. Any files? Anything? Nope. Just a giant-ass red button. What is this gonna do? Airlock? Follow the... Oh, thank God. For a second there, wait. Damn. Oh, shit. Hey, buddy. Hi, buddy. Shit, I'm stuck on the door. Excuse me, buddy. Sorry. Gotta go. That was a close one. Anthony asked, how is everybody? Give him a chance. Ah, see, there's the guys who don't wear pants. What?
Job-like in the suppression of our desires. But now we indulge. Yes. His tongue and his
Gentlemen, I'm just gonna go this way. I wonder if Tweedledee and Tweedledum have realized, like, is it possible he might have gone out that broken window and shimmying across? Nah, he's not that smart. Something tells me I'm supposed to get... Oh, yeah. Of course. Shit. Please don't tell me they're there. No, they're not. How the fuck did they get around? You know what? On second thought, let's not ask. Take a look at alright. Proper purge gate maintenance is crucial to Project Wildrider security. Please refer to Murkoff maintenance manual or seek guidance from a supervisor. That's a secret file? Oh, come on. I got files like that at work all the time. That's not a secret. It's basically saying, hey, let me boil it down to you. If you don't know what you're doing, ask your supervisor for advice. Thank you and good night. Ooh, huh. That's security. Oh, is Matt Beard, the person who's currently... Is this by any relation to the... I really wish I knew the rest of the name for him. Beard from, from Twitter. Is it? Yeah, I ask a question, and you'll... Oh! Oh, crap. There's our giant friend. I can't shake Chris Walker, the big, ugly fucker who likes to rip people's heads off. I hear him muttering about security protocols, containment. What if he's not the problem? What if he's trying to fix it? Yeah, that guy's got the right idea. Run flailing your hands! Ah, thanks, officer. I'm just gonna take this and, gain access to the shower room? Yeah. You know what? I'm just gonna close this from high on security. Thank you. Swap out my battery real quick. I gotta be careful in this asylum. This isn't exactly a game that they just simply leave you off the hook. or maybe they're being friendly, since I'm right now in the bowels of hell. Correction, I just walked into the bowels of hell. And man, the bowels of hell could really use a can of Comet, bleach. Well, at least you can play your favorite radio. Yeah, I'm pretty sure the radio reception down here would be ass, though. Great, I'm gonna escape through the sewers. Shawshank Redemption time, bitches. Hey there, big guy. Who also happens to be not wearing pants. Oh my god. Okay, note to self, hearing footprints behind you is not good. Alright. Escape through the sewers. Another question is, how the fuck am I supposed to escape? Oh, I know what I'm supposed to do. Adios, motherfuckers! No, I think you're sick fucks. So now I got Tweedledee and Tweedledum after me. Okay, you know what just came to realization? We could climb to that pipe and slide down and just escape from here. Yeah, like, why don't we just do that? You know, like a normal survivor would do. Oh, that's a wall. That's not a pipe. You know what? I'm really honestly, in real life, this would happen to me. I'm willing to take a risk and fall and break my legs in order just to simply escape this freaking hellhole. You know, like a normal person. But for video game convenience and plot devices, we're just going to continue. Man, I got a feeling that the developers of this game actually got, whoa, little glitch right there, got some influences from the TV show MTV's Fear. Oh god, why'd I do that? You know what, why did I do that? You know what, because I'm an idiot, that's why! And thank you, Anthony, for having you on the show. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. I got a feeling that door is not going to hold him. Oh, ah! What is it with him and throwing me out of windows? Thanks for catching my camera, by the way. Find an alternate path to the showers. No shit. Let's just survey the situation. Oh, crap. Hey, woodsman. Welcome back. I'm dealing with surviving against a freaking giant walking nightmare named Chris Walker. Who's also walking, because technically, yeah, he's living his name. I actually have 8 people watching this live stream. I'm actually really happy about that right now. Oh, that guy is huge. Alright, I got a plan. It's not a very good one, but at least it will do. Aha! Chris Walker, you're too amazingly buff to get through! Ah, shit! Oh. Yeah, I would do the same thing and stay away from that Walker guy. He's, very big and very angry. I don't like the look of this. I guess you could say, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the main event. Railing death. Wow, MST3K was actually right. Railings do kill.
What's the experiment? The dead will perform on the living. It's still happening. The experiment is still happening.
He did not kill his animals. Listen, buddy, I'm a witness. Alright. Dr. Rudolph G. Winneker. A winner. Age 90. God damn. He lived a long time. Alright. Passed away doing the work he loved. February 28th, 2009. Born in 1918 in Munich, Germany. And achieved fame in mathematic and scientific communities for a paper written within the early computing pioneer Al Turing. After a cloudy history with German war effort, he immigrated to the United States in 1949 with a visa from the State Department. Several decades of government research in Los Alamos led to New Mexico, where Dr. Wynn retired to pursue his landscape photography and care of his cats. Of course he had a cat. Why not? He came to Colorado shortly after the turn of the millennium to pursue charitable work for the Murkoff Corporation. A statement from the company calls Dr. a true humanitarian with a generous spirit. He leaves no survivors. So we might have a possible Nazi on our hands. If I explain all the fucked up research. Easy.
Hey.
Ow, fucker!
Cockfucker! There! You just made us look in at our own reflections!
Well, god damn it! I knew that would happen! It's always down the drain. And Detective Rolls just came online. Last night we actually did free battery. We did a live stream of GTA's new stunt racing. Yeah, me, TJ, and Detective Rolls. We actually had a lot of fun doing that. Shit. Let's see, which way should we go? Follow the blood, I guess. Wall Rider. The word Wall Rider is all over the place. Murkoff was running an experiment here called Project Wall Rider. But the patients talk about Wall Rider like it's a physical presence, a spirit or demon, something they found in the mountain. I chalk it up to schizophrenia delusion, but maybe I just saw something. Maybe. Maybe it was a glitch in the camera, or maybe this place is getting to me. Going further underground. Okay, those are just bricks. Find a way out of the sewer. Great. Man, last time I was in a sewer like this, it was Dead Island. Wait, no, it wasn't Dead Island. It was Dying Lights. No, there was one in Dead Island, too. I got a feeling we're running the Chris Walker down here. Because why not? This seems like a hellhole he would play in. Or call home. Or we could run into Killer Croc. That would help, too. Well, at least we found the light at the end of the tunnel. Whoa! Okay, now I'm even more scared of this game. That was a freaking black shadow, ghastly hunter thingy. Yeah, let's go this way. Let's not take the obvious reason where we just saw a possible supernatural entity. Flush the water by turning two valves. Oh, people don't even flush? Come on. Whoa, let me guess. Of course it had to be him. Fuck. Ah, crap, our giant heavyweight friend found us. Hey, Ugly, how you doing? You forgot leg day, didn't you? You know, they say that's an important day. Ah, I'm tiny. Bye-bye. Yeah, it's always a good idea. Piss off the big, giant, angry ape. Whoops, excuse me. I'm wondering, did Game Grumps ever do a Let's Play this game? Is that behind me or... Or, oh, right in front of me. Juicy, I don't think there's a female ward, and if there is in this game, let's not go there. Besides, I'm kind of more focused on, you know, that supernatural entity we just saw fucking just hover by. Hey, got achievement unlocked. Flushed. Crap, here comes tons of fun. Is there any way to get around him? Save the battery juice. And there's tons of fun. Don't tell me you can smell me. You can smell me. Oh, thank God. It was just a fucking guessing game. Okay. I'm gonna be following a freaking Brock Lesnar wannabe. Walking. Let me just tell you this. Having Turtle Beach headsets can be a curse. At the same time, an absolute blessing. You can hear footsteps, you can do all sorts of crazy shit. Okay, where'd he go? You still have to chase me, fat man. I wonder how Chris Walker is on ladders. He's a walker, not a climber. Ugh. Not a way I would want to go. Hey, buddy, you okay? No? Okay. Ugh. I didn't even get up there. Jeez, what happened to friggin' arms? This guy must have been here for a while to be rotting like that. Man. Excuse me, sir. Would you like to respond and how you feel about the sanitation of Mount Asylum? Okay. Duly noted. Huh. Looks like we found the light at the end of the tunnel again. And also, to answer your question, what's been up? Oh, crap. Answer your question, Woodsman? Yes, I have met the brothers. I call them Tweedledee and Tweedledum. And there was someone up there. Find a way out of the sewers. No shit! Okay, Let's not go that way. Especially since it sounds incredibly painful. Okay, I think either the brothers have found...
You don't have to be scared of me. I can tell we're the same. You still know what's real. The doctor's dead, you know that, right? Dr. Wernicke died before he even started working here. What kind of experiments does a dead doctor perform on living patients? That's the question.
He's actually making good sense. Patient, no, Dr. Veer is dead. One asks, what kind of experience does a dead doctor perform on a living patient? What is Project Wall Rider? What is Project Wall Rider? Why can't Pokemon Go have an actual stable connection? And also, for a second, that humming, that singing there, reminded me a lot of the, that's a lot of blood. Oh. Yeah, we know. Juicy was right. And we're going to go to the mail ward because I have a feeling that's the way we're supposed to go. Hold on a second, though. Let's go the other way. Yeah, that singing reminded me of the skeleton from One Piece. Oh. And true Dark Soul. Shit, I'm down to one last battery. Oh yeah, let's go down the hallway of nothing but blood, guts, and a leaky pipe. I didn't like the sound of that. You know what? Let's not open that door. Yeah, let's go down the bloody tunnel. That sounds a lot better. God, I hate confined spaces like this. Let's see, right or left? Let's go left. Okay, multiple times, or let's not. Oh, I was out. That's good. Also, fun little fact, guys. Every time I say Chris Walker, that giant freaking gorilla human, I always want to say Chris Pratt for some reason, but I'm like, that's not even close. Let's not go that way. And shut the door because we don't want anything chasing after us. I don't know what that is, but let's go this way. Whatsoever. I don't like this. At least I got one less battery. Make it count. Excuse me, you have a battery you can spare me? I guess that's a no. I guess I can't crouch in water. Makes sense. Shit! I'm saving. Great. Either somebody just strummed a very awesome chord on a guitar, or something bad's about to happen. Let's go with strumming an awesome guitar chord. Crap, he's down here. Just like with a maze, put your hand on the right wall, and eventually it'll get you out. I got a feeling this strategy isn't working. No, but the battery there will. Oh, come on, really? What the fuck am I supposed to do? We'll swap out this. Oh, I'm supposed to grab the ladder. Big fuckers down here with me, I can hear them. Well, hopefully the aquatic training will slow them down. Ha ha! You okay, buddy? Hey, listen, buddy. I got a big angry friend down there. You might not want to go down there. Whew. Or maybe, shit. Oh fuck. Did he lock me out? Well, to be fair, I did just kind of try to screw him over. Okay, where did that guy go? Ooh, need that. He's gonna come running at me. Of blood. All right, we follow Straight Jacket Eddie here. I don't like the sound of that, so I'm just gonna go up here. Reach the ground floor of the male ward. Why the fuck would I do that? Seriously, dude. What is with everybody? Is pants, like, not necessary in this asylum? Listen, buddy. Seriously, get some pants. Ugh. Hmm? First fingers, then balls, then tongue? Lovely. Organized torture. The harder I try to escape, the further I get into this god-awful place, like fighting a tar pit. They've been torturing people in the basement and by method written in the wall. Fingers first, then balls, then tongue. Somebody managed the torture, instructing them. Are these the brothers I'm going to be meeting? Hey, just a guy I just watched here. Okay, you know what? Since something big is coming this way, it's probably our Chris Walker friend. Fuck. And one of my friends on my friends list just got free advertisement. Okay, I got a feeling that is not gonna hold up too much longer. Are you shitting me? Hey buddy, I'm about to do something you're probably not gonna like. Oh, they got a camera down here? Probably a snuff film racket or something. Where'd that guy go? Oh shit. Well, I think we made it to the operating room. This isn't something straight out of Metal Gear Solid 5. Fuck. Apparently that guy's a watchdog or something. Well, those must be the brothers. Hey, brothers!
Go around! We'll flatten you! This is the experiment!
Oh shit. Oh crap, they just throw me back into the fold. Oh! Shit! Fuck.
Thank you.
some parkour. Swear to God, these guys are freaking having a purge right now. Oh, that was fun. Of course, there's always another door.
You can't hide!
Shit. Next floor, please. Thank you. Some possible survivors?
You need a chase here, buddy.
Whoa! A Cenobite?
Hey, you're that bullshit priest's guy, aren't you? His witness or whatever. You must be exhausted. Let's take a break, huh, buddy? The old 2 martini lunch? Hmm? Have a little confab, blah, blah.
Oh, fuck.
Failure than you look. A little cardio wouldn't kill you. Okay, here we go. Arms and legs inside the car at all times.
I think we just met the doctor. Oh, fuck. To be honest, I wouldn't mind having a martini lunch, though. Hey, Doc, can you do me a favor? Can you just have the camera rolling the whole entire time?
You know, I love the mountain air up here at night. You want to head out and take a stroll? Go ahead, I'll wait here. Go on, run free! I'm in no hurry. No? All right. Nose to the grindstone, I like that. Okay, then, right this way.
Ah, so close yet so far. Since obviously I'm not going anywhere, should I just call you Doctor? Or Verg? Quite the setup you got on your arm right there. So, this Project Wall Rider. Care to tell me about it?
Kill me.
You're putting that tongue to any use anyway. Truth be told, I was just tired of licking my own stairs.
I don't disagree with you there. Seriously, sanitation can use a little bit
here
of work.
Here we are, then. Thanks so much for coming by. We'll begin your consultation in a moment. We'll just need a second to wash up and, no movies. And it'll give us a chance to talk.
That's lovely. This is gonna become a fucking snuff film. Great.
You know, I'm a bit worried how much time you've been spending with Father Martin. I know, I hope you haven't been letting him confuse you with all his holier-than-thou Bible-thumping. No offense to the man, but I sometimes worry he might just be a little bit lazy. It's understandable if people get scared. There's like to turn to God as anything else. I mean, God died with the gold standard. We're onto a more concrete faith now. You have to rob Paul to pay Peter. There's no other way. Murder in it is the simplest form, but what happens when all the money's gone?
Monica, you're talking about surgery and money?
And that's what I'm here for. Make you believe. You paying attention? Don't pass out on me. There's still a lot for you to absorb.
God, fuck! Is this guy the Scissorman?
Better now, right? You understand how we cheat here? We made the consumer into the means of production. This thing is gonna sell itself!
Okay, he took my ring finger and my... Could have done that the whole fucking time. Of course, why not? Well, to be fair, that isn't as... If you get enough pain, you will puke. Great, now that I've experienced that much amount of pain... Now that I experienced that much level of pain, my freaking hair is gonna turn white now. Doc, I was just having a chat with your lovely friend here. By the way, he seems to be a bit of a dick. Elevator needs a key. Seriously? Well, off I go, I guess. Aw, man, I can't believe the fucker took my ring finger.
Quitter.
Yeah, but I'd rather live.
Hey,
I have no choice. I think I need to run past him.
Hold up there, buddy.
I'll be right with you.
Did I just... I just went in a goddamn circle back to where I started.
I need you to be working with me here, buddy.
Yeah, this guy is definitely the definition of the scissorman. Which brings up the question, if they can make this guy, how long until they make another Clock Tower game?
Let me tell you the dream!
Ah, shit. Buddy, you mind if I jump over you? No? Oh, shit. And you mind? I'm occupied. Thank you. Thanks. Going on.
That's who I am.
Ah, shit. I'm dead. All right. Okay. All right, guys. Saving, and all right, guys. This seems like a good time to take a break. Oh, man. Shit. This story's getting really interesting. So let's see. We have the brothers. Chris Walker, and now the Doctor, who looks like a fucking Cenobite from Hellraiser. Alright. Well, to everybody who watched this live stream, thank you very much. Ah, man. Yeah, Jessica, this is the end of the stream, guys. Thank you very much for watching. Greatly appreciate it. If you enjoyed this live stream as well as just all Let's Plays in general, follow me here on Twitch. I live stream every night. And yeah, Matt Beard is right now. He's just, all this guy wanted to be was a better journalist, and he got tons of pain, his fingers cut off, and whatever in that urinal. Man, fuck. This game is just, and the worst part is, there's a sequel, ladies and gentlemen, and I'll be getting it. So if you enjoy live streams, as well as Let's Plays, follow me here on Twitch, as well as be sure to follow me on YouTube as well. I port these live streams over there so you can watch them again if you want to, because God knows on Twitch they don't last that long. And also, you can watch other fun Let's Plays on there. As of right now, I'm doing a Let's Play of Perfect Dark right now, the old N64 edition. Well, not the N64 edition, but Perfect Dark in general. I want to thank Matt Beard for joining us, as well as Woodsman, as well as Juicy, as well as everybody else who just came in, who I happen to catch their names. Just a Guy, Woodsman, Anna, thank you very much for watching. Luke, Anthony, thank you very much for watching, guys. Greatly appreciate it. I got a lot of people to thank, but I wouldn't be here without them. So be sure to follow me on Facebook and Twitter for updates about live streams, as well as when I go live. Oh, not much else I can say, guys, except, well, thank you for watching. I'm the Madman, and good luck getting sleep tonight. I don't know if I'll get some. Until next time, I'm the Madman, and I think the mental asylum's getting to me.